Hi, John here. Today's Thursday, 13th of October, 2016. I'm just going to ring Sunakura in Gisborne, down the east coast where I come from. And she's heavily involved with the Confederation of Chiefs, and more likely she is one of the last proficient scholars in all the history and the land title titles in this country, New Zealand. Okay, so I've been involved with her and Kingi Taurua on the Marae radio, Radio Waitea, 6:03 a.m. for many years, talking about this particular subject, the flag of King William the Fourth. So I'll give her a ring and let her know what is going on. She's the Maori government. Yeah, hi Sue, it's John Wanoa here. I'll try and ring you a little later, just for the 28th of October, that's what I'm calling about, and Waitangi. Okay? I'll catch you later. Bye. Yeah, it's Sue Nakora. Obviously she's either resting up or gone out. It's a little bit early at the moment. She's usually up at 3 in the morning. And she probably got a lot to do. She's responsible for going to the United Nations, taking a delegation there of chiefs around the country in the four regions. Te Tai Tokoro, that's north. Te Tai Ra Whiti, that's east. And Te Tai Tonga, that's south. And Te Tau Hau Uru, that's west of New Zealand. Four tribes make up this flag of jurisdiction in those areas of land titles. The first, very first land titles. I'm involved with that and her in the original titles in Gisborne, where the titles were put together, land titles were put together, and still are. More so now in the Marae Land Court. All the last registrations are there. So I'm looking after that commercial area of land titles and whose names are on those titles, the Marae Land Court titles. On one side, on that side, we'll say the Queen is on the left side, and the British titles on the right side of that flag. So I go left for Queen. This is the side that the commercial business is running under John Key, versus Sue Nakora in the Confederation on that side. So most of her speak, talk, and with the iwi Maori, and with the Confederation of Chiefs in this country, are on this side, the Queen's side. All their documents are addressing to the Queen. And on this side, it addresses to the King's commercial side. Queen's side left, King's side right. Flag. No flag. Okay, no flag. John Key. And the Confederation still uses this flag on this side. Because of their documents. The documents that have Maori on it comes under the iwi on this side. On this side there's no Maori. On the British title there is no Maori. There was no word Maori at 1830 to 1837 under King William the Fourth. There was no Maori, only native. Okay? So we've put Moai, memorial statue, that the Crown corporations on this side, King's Crown corporations, gave it 300 AD as being that's far enough back. So this one and Kupe's 800-900 AD go together. Okay, and the eight tribes of Whakameninga, this side. I've got the history from Mohi Manukau here of the eight tribes of Nga Puhi fighting against Ngāti Whātua. Okay, and his tribe of people. So, just to be distinction between the two contracts. This is for the Confederation of Chiefs to make sure they don't mix them up. They don't mix the both sides up, because on this side, the British side, I'm operating the flag which has gone around the world, and it's no longer local business. It is commercial, international business here. This side of this flag, on this side, with the Maori land courts, are under John Key, Maori land courts to New South Wales, Australia, government in exile. Okay, so that side contract is fighting with the Crown Queen Elizabeth and Queen Victoria on this side. Men, woman. Woman, trouble. Corruption, fraud on this side. Nothing on this side. It's all on this side. The King looks after the people in the High Court. The Queen looks after no one but herself and her private contracts. Right? You see the difference? The contracts on this side was between the King, King William IV, and the Hapu native chiefs. Okay? They were trading already, and they needed a trading flag on their land because it was getting swamped by this side, by the Queen side, New South Wales and Queen Victoria side. It's getting swamped out. Right? They had the money on this side, the New South Wales money, dollar. No money, just trade with goods and logs, trees, whatever. On this side, fish and vegetables, stuff like this for this side here at the time. Okay, we're talking about 1834 here, and we're talking about 1835 here. The Constitution and the flag is 1835. Comes on this side. Okay? This side wasn't set up yet. They only designed the flag here, and the Constitution 1835 was put together on this side. Okay? So this was a contract in the beginnings because of the real estate pre-sale of land at Kororareka. Russell. The British and Australian Crown corporations sold the land at Russell while the ship came over and landed with that contract in their hand to show, once they opened their paper up and showed the land belongs to the King, that was a contract by default of the King. Okay? The King put it together. And if a native chief went over there, he would have been native from Nga Puhi. Okay? He would have been native from Nga Puhi. I won't say any names because I'll leave that for the chiefs to say that. And that native person who made a deal with the King of England to give them a flag. When he gave them a flag, that's when the contract started, when the British landed their ship on that land. Okay? So this side, a year later, 1835, that's what we're coming up to now, the 28th of October, Declaration of Independence Day. On this side, this is where they put the combined chiefs through the whole country together to enhance the flag's jurisdiction of Admiralty from the King on this side. So that's the constitution, and the flag was acknowledged. The first flag on this side was acknowledged by the King on this side. The contract had already started in 1834 by dropping in on the land and proclaiming the land belonged to the King. That's it. That's the contract. Okay? I've got it all here from Mohi Manukau and Hare Utatonga. Okay? No one can inquire into that because it's a private contract between that chief and his descendants and the King of England, Britain, UK. So now we're in this side on the 28th of October. This side, the 10th of April 2016, was 182 years of the flag landing and settling on the Nga Puhi Hapu's native land. Okay, so you had to have a piece of paper, which is the contract, to occupy the land. That's all it was, an occupation title. When the white man came and went onto that land, he said it's his. Okay, that's how commerce works. That's how we're going to work this whole business of the Moai Crown Commonwealth Government of the world is on this side. Is on this side. Right? Starting from here, the first contract. It's more our first mortgage because the banks lent money under a contract. Right? These are private contracts between the King and the chiefs. Private. Nobody else's business. So it's still the same today. It's still a private contract because it hasn't been altered. We haven't gone to Westminster yet to alter it. I'm going there with Kingi Taurua because he's the last man on his feet standing on Te Ti Marae, Ture Flag. I just want to make this clear with all the Ngā Puhis, Whakameninga, that because Kingi's on the piece of land at Waitangi, where the ship is, with its mast, that is the British title. With this flag to fly on the top, is the title under the British documents I have here. Doctrines of Discovery title was right there. Okay? We have this flag on the Waitangi Treaty Grounds, transferred from Te Ngāere and the other ship, the first ship on Kororareka, Mikey Hill, that ship's mast is up the top of the hill at the highest point. When the flag flies at the highest point or in Urupā with its memorial to the tūpunas or the ancestors, that's the power. That is the overruling power, the same as in Auckland. John Campbell, they put their title there, but the chief is buried underneath that hill first. Okay, and the memorial to Kawharu, the giant of Waikato, sits there, and the Pākehā in Auckland, John Key's government, was rude enough to put a footpath right over it. The plaque is still there, the memorial is missing. I went up there with Mahi Manukau because these are Manukau land, Auckland, whole of Auckland, straight from Scotland, Britain, UK, Manukau Land Company, real estate company, note, real estate company, that sold Auckland, and they came over with Captain William Simon, William Cornwallis Simon, Captain, surrogate king of England, surrogate King William the Fourth, came in and occupied the land with the same piece of paper, proclamation, the land belongs to the king. That's what we're talking about, Kingi. You, being on both sides, you're on the crown side, under Queen Victoria on the left side, with Queen Elizabeth, monarch, reigning monarch, on the left side to sort out. You have to sort this out, and this lot, but at the same time you're on this side. On that marae, there is nobody else that's going to talk about you, because you're the oldest. In the tikanga Māori law, L-O-R-E, the chief that's the oldest has the last say. He gives consent in an upper house on this side. Okay, the upper house is on this side because this is British. The upper house on this left side is the Confederation. Right, two sets. This is the world, this is just New Zealand. Right, left, New Zealand, Queen Victoria, Queen Elizabeth, chiefs of the iwi Māori. On the left, remember that. On the right is King William Corporation and the Hapu, native, and the Moai crown title, mana whenua, here. Tangata whenua on this side, on the left, with the queen, and the iwi Māori, mana whenua, I was here. I saw your ship come in and land on my native land. This side said that. This side here, in the meantime, are struggling against John Key's government and the Crown Corporation's trade. This side is still locked in a contract with Britain, the Navy, British Navy, and the military and Westminster Parliament, this side. No one can alter it, only us, the chiefs. You only need one chief, and me as being the Māori Crown, Commonwealth, Government of the World, Native Land Commissioner, right? Because I've got all the documents here. There's no one going to argue against that. There's no one proficient enough to talk like that without the documents and the titles, the original titles to Britain. Okay, I've got Sue Nakura on this side to cover me for all the native titles in Gisborne. They're all in the office there. They've shut down other offices of the Māori Land Corps and only got Hamilton, I think Christchurch, and Gisborne. That's it. The Māori titles, King Land titles, will phase out and there'll be no more Māori land titles on the left side. These titles will be John Key's government in Wellington. This side, in the meantime, is British Hapu Commonwealth Government of the World titles. This goes around the world with this flag. The left side stays on the ground with this flag as domestic. It's a home flag. It's got to fix its land up. It takes a long time. This one, I'm in the sea with the Moai tidal turbines right around the world with this one. 250 countries that we're advertising at the moment. Now I just want to make this point clear that our business should have been doing that long ago. It should have been shipping around the world, flying around the world with this flag flying. That's why I engaged with the Navy, John Harrison. Now he's alerted the cultural advisors and the other people, the top top leaders and the Chief of Navy. He's alerting them to what the events are going to be on the 28th, 5 in the morning, and they're expected to be there. We're hoping that they'll do the honourable thing for us to give this flag a 21-gun salute marking 182 years of British landing in this country. Okay? They've all come out of that. All the Pākehā out here, or European and British, have come here under this flag. There is no other way you can go from one country to the other without a flag of some sorts. Okay? So the flag is a bank flag. It bought the commerce as well, and the trading bank from the Bank of England, which is King William's Acts of Parliament, 1832-1837. Those are the bank acts we're using in this flag for this side, the King's Commerce. Right? The King's Crown, Sovereign, Monarch, and Marae Crown, Hapu, Native Partnership. Okay? Locked in this flag. Locked in the flag as the contract of discovery of title to New Zealand from Britain. Okay, so we got that clear. And the left side, it's the same flag, 1834 on this side, 1835 on that side. That's got mixed up with the iwi Māori and John Key's government in Wellington. Okay, they're fighting a battle over the land. They've got to sort the land out on that side with the flag, and this side is around the world. Two different scenarios, and to Willie Pater and Hohepa, EPR, and the Whakameninga, you have to know which sides are which. You can't mix them both, because there's two contracts here running. There's two contracts with land, and unless you're proficient in land, and the documentation, and the titles, and the names, the right names, that are stuck on the title of succession. You can't change the name into a adopted name or whangai name. You can't do that with this title. The British have got the names on the titles, okay, on this side. On this side, you've got bodgy names. You've got mixed Māori, Pākehā names and some names that are not real. They are not real. You have to watch that because it'll jeopardize your titles on your land. And this side will sort it out. Because Suna Kora's got the original titles with the names on it, the urupas on it, marked. Nobody gets to see that. Only the Confederation named Confederation of Chiefs of the Tribes of Aotearoa and me. Okay? Not a privilege for anybody else to see private information that's only the Confederation members. For Mohi Manukau and Hareu Tutonga, Rishikake and Machi Taurua, Mohi Manukau and Suna Kora gave me their titles. Right, that's it. That's the Confederation. Ohepa, EPR, watching the video. You need to have those, but you don't know the connections all the way through. Before 1986 constitution on this side, on the left side with John Key changing it, that was Geoffrey Palmer, and Suna Kora was in the Labour Party then as the Māori she did the history of the native land titles for Geoffrey Palmer. Okay, they put them together for the 1986 constitution from the 1952 constitution. They changed it. But she's on both sides. Just the same as Kingi. Kingi is on both sides. These are the two people that have been strict on me all these years. In fact, Kingi, operating on this side when I first met him, told me to shut up, sit down, and don't say anything. You know, every time he says, sit down. Not anymore. Not anymore, because he understands how the two work. Even at his age, he knows. And it's his tupuna is telling him, look, you have to appease both sides, the king's side and the queen's side. So with Kingi, his ancestors are Edward, King Edward, and to Queen Victoria. That is his title on that land on this side, the Crown Corporation side, to New Zealand. Okay? To New Zealand, to Australia, to Britain. So he's got a longer path to get to Britain. This side, I'm taking him from this side straight to Britain. Don't need anybody else. It's just like John Key, Prime Minister. He goes all over the world by himself. Well, I'm saying in the politicians. He can go anywhere and travel and make decisions for the whole country, including Maoris on their side. That's John Key on that side can talk anything he likes for Maori because they own Maori. They own Maori, the word, the documents, the everything. The Maryland Court and the titles in the Maryland Court, not the titles in the British. Okay? Not the British title, only the ones they altered from this side. They've sold a land off on this side. This one here didn't sell land. Okay, put the title together. Okay? On the commercial side, only the Navy had the title from the King, the first title. That's their title to occupy the land from Britain at Kororareka. Okay? Kororareka, and at Waitangi a year later on that side. I hope I make myself clear, Kohepa, because I think you're in discussions now with the Whakameninga and the Taumata, Kaumatua of Nga Puhi. I want to be clear with you is that the Taumata's job is to look after the land and its marae. It can't get mixed up in politics and land titles and commercial contracts. It can't. It can't. Because it jeopardizes its own self. So you have to leave those jobs. I can't do your job and you can't do my job. Because you won't have everything. Everything. And you'll notice that my court case against the police in Auckland worked. They lost. They lost against a land title cover-up on the fraud mortgage. So, unless you know how to do that, and go into Waitangi Marae against the grain of the Crown Corporation of John Key's government, and the Iwi Māori, and the Waitangi National Trust Corporation, unless you can go in there yourself and start talking, there's no way in hell you can't do it without titles, or land titles I'm talking about, and history to go with it on every piece of land in this country. I've got the Manukau land title and its name all over South Island, from Motueka down with the Parapara title. I've got the Parapara title at, and the Manukau title here, and the Manukau title on Chatham Islands, and in North Island. Okay, all those titles are British titles on this side. On this side, right? The Manukau heads, the Manukau Harbour, Captain William Cornwallis Simon came with his title, real estate title, from Britain through the Manukau real estate company in Scotland, and did the same thing as they did in Russell, Kororareka. They did the same thing there and there. That's Plymouth, New Plymouth, Plymouth to England, Devon, Devonport, Auckland, Navy, to Devon, Port, William Yard, Navy, where they came from. Okay, you get the picture? The title's on the other end with King William's Memorial in the William Yard, the biggest Navy military in those days, 1830-1837. He put that together from 50 years in the Navy. So I'm here for him, to speak for him, and to write for him and his successor, King Ernest Augustus V, on this side, King's Commerce side, with the flag and his son, Ernest Augustus, Prince Regent, on his side. He's about 38 now, and Ernest Augustus, the fifth king, is 68. Okay, so that's our connection to Britain with Matt Taylor, the leader of the Moai King William Party, and the leader of the company we have registered there, Moai Powerhouse Group Limited, in the company's house, UK, London, Britain. Now, he is the commercial side of this flag partner over there. Okay, that's our partner. And Jackie Littler Gordon is my secretary in Scotland, Aberdeenshire, three-quarter of an hour down from Balmoral Castle. Okay, in Scotland is the secretary of our British connection right now. So that's where Glasgow, she's not far from Glasgow, where these titles came from, all these titles here in this country. Okay, I make myself clear, Ohepa? No one else can talk like that, not even in Auckland. Those two titles, those two king's titles, forms this country's legacy under this commercial flag. Bank, trading bank flag. Why didn't you people know that? Why? There's no use talking about it now. You should have known all this way back. Just have to leave that all to me now. And do your Taumata job on the Marae in Nga Puhi, the eight tribes that Mohi Manukau wrote for me. He wrote it up in his own handwriting, and I typed it out on his documents, his title documents I have here. I will sort the Manukau's titles out when I've finished doing all the Ututonga titles on the lands in the Bay of Islands, and then it's Cook Street here, and the Manukau land titles here I'll put back in its place. And the East Cape titles in the Poverty Bay and Bay of Plenty area where I come from, I will stitch those titles together as it was back then, on this side with the pound note, levy debtor instrument, and the British King William the Fourth Laws 1832-1837 applies on this side of commerce. In fact, we can go back to the hanging rope on this side. Severe punishment in the district courts in this country and around the world in the Commonwealth countries. So now we have Moai Crown Commonwealth Countries of the World, NWO, New World Order. New World Order. Okay, 8-point star on the flag, New World Order. Four corners of the earth, four stars. North, east, south, west, Ngā Hau e Whā, Ngā Atua e Wā. Aotea is the company here, registered in the company's office, Wellington. Okay, that's that company. Two companies, one here and one in Britain, registered. Two different scenarios, this one and this one. Okay, Ngā Atua e Wā Aotea Limited is on this side, on the Queen's side, in Wellington, and operating its commercial business from this side, right, in the laws of this side. The Crimes Act 1961 and the Crimes Act 1951 applies to Cook Street, 67 Cook Street, to Caesar, on this side, with this title, and the Manukau land title. Okay, the original Manukau land title applies to Cook Street. That's what I've been trying to tell everybody all along. Ohepa? I've been trying to tell everybody all along, but no one's listening. No one's listening, and it cost them. And the consequence of not listening is their loss, okay? You start losing when you go into court. If anybody's name is on any of those documents, you're going to court by default of this side's title overriding rule of law, British law, the 1838-1837, has got the original titles that this side pulled out, all the X, so that they wouldn't get trapped in commerce on this side. Well, unfortunately for John Key on this side, on the left side, he gets strung up from this side. It's still a contract, the private contract, that this side has with the iwi Maori, okay? The iwi Maori has taken the power off the hapu for themselves, and if they're using this flag, if John Key's government and their agents, crown corporations, even the Waitangi Marae, trust using this flag for their commercial business without the consent of the Whakameninga tribes, eight tribes, those are all the Nga Puhi tribes, the eight tribes, Whakameninga, they're in trouble. That's where I come in. However, that's where I come in. Because there's no one else that can talk like that capacity and authority to correct the books. Audit the books in Britain, not here. You can't do it here. You can't run things here. Gotta go to Britain and get the British to do it, because they're obligated under contract with us to audit the books on that side, on the left side, because it was the British Westminster government that allowed John Key and the Australian government and all the Commonwealth governments to do what they do, and they're using this side's native titles on that side. Australia got caught out. They were going to the New South Wales, Canberra, the Attorney General, and the government there was going to swear their oath of office in their court, when they were opening their court, to Queen Victoria. I wrote to them and put a video to them and rang them up and told them, no, you can't. No, you can't. You'll get fired with their flag. And so, they stopped. They stopped. If I didn't do that, they would have overruled all the titles here in New Zealand, because that's where they came from, here. Okay, they shifted from Sydney to Victoria, Victoria into Canberra. That title from Britain, under this King William the Fourth, Victoria. Okay? You see now? Now, if you don't know all of that, you're in trouble. If you start tampering with information like the police did with Cook Street, tampering with this information, contract. Waitangi, Auckland, one contract. Manukau, British, under the flag. Left side, Queen, Waitangi, two contracts. Kororareka, Navy arrives, 1834, 10th of April. Stepped on a land contract. He says, that's my land, all that bit over there. See? You need a piece of paper with a name on it. That's the contract. Somebody signed it, you see. And so, they shifted and put the other ship, Navy, from them, a year later, 28th of October, 1835, on Kororareka land, Russell, and hoisted that ship on dry land. Two ships on dry land, off the sea. Admiralty, Sea of Admiralty, flag. Right? Sea of Admiralty flag, under this flag, King William IV, reign, sovereign, monarch. Got it? That's all I want to say, but Sunakora knows all of this, and I just wanted to ring her up to tell her he has a job to do for her Maori government, you see, on this side. Maori government on this side. She's got to battle them. There's nobody else got documents as straight as hers, because she was working in the government with John Key and his jump ship. So when you jump ship like waka jumping, That's what's been happening with the Maori and politics in this country. I hope she picks that up. Oh, no. It's unfortunately, it's on answer phone. And so I was hoping to talk to her before the 28th to see if she can come up, fly up to Russell, and I will pick her up. If she comes up, I'm hoping that my friend Hoffman in Rotorua will come up. Okay, she will come up. And we will both go up together like last time with Sunakora. That's her friend, Sunakora. Okay? I'll just forget her name now. Hoffman. But anyway, she's a nice woman living in Rotorua. I've stayed in her home there. And we get on all right. And so that name, Russell, that's her maiden name, is Russell, from Russell, up in Kororareka. So she tells me everything about them, how bad they are, how bad her people are to Maoris. And she's passionate about Maoris, and especially Nga Puhi. So she has a wealth of knowledge on the English side of the equation and the German side of her husband, Hoffman. Okay, my friend Kurt Hoffman and his mum. Are very good friends of mine. So, anyway, now that I can't get a hold of her, I'll just ring Willie Peter, because I was going to talk to him anyway for the hui this week. Willie, how are you? Okay, hey, you still got your hui this week? Did you still want me to come up or not? Oh, next week. What day about? Wednesday, what time? 10 o'clock, okay. So I'll do a bit of presentation on what was going to happen on the 28th. And is that all right? Otherwise, it can't happen. I don't have to go through with it. If I can't get communication with the Whakameninga, it's all over. I'm saying that right now because I can turn it all off. There's no need to go in that marae. If I don't do that, that's the end of everyone. Because the New World Order is coming in the next month. November is all over. That's as far as I know what's happening with the... With yeah? Yeah, so that's their job. They've got to go, but they can't mess up with the commerce. The Taumata can't do commercial banking. That's what I'm saying. And history. They can look after the land, but I'm going into the sea and off to London, around the world with the flag. Two parts of the flag, the world and domestic here, from that marae, on the land. So Ngā Puhi will do its thing with the flag on the land. Well, I've hired the marae, the Waitangi marae, where the title is. If Ngā Puhi doesn't want the title, then Kingi's going to step in and do it with me and him. You see, because it's too late. He's not in the field where I am with the titles and Mohi Manuka and all the Confederation. they have not got all those titles. I've got them all here. Yeah, with the flag, I'm talking. Yeah, where? Yeah, where, Tiki or Waitangi? Because I'm organising the Navy to 21-gun salute and all the rest of it, because no, they won't listen to anybody. They won't listen. I've managed to get through again to get that marae for this occasion. It's on, I sent the thing to you, the agenda. Yeah. Well, I have to send it by post. So you get it, so you might not get it, you see. It's very important that you fellows know what the Navy is doing. Because they've got the agenda already. They're following what... No, I have to explain it, because this, nobody can do this. No. Yeah, that's what I, it's all on video anyway, it's on YouTube, everybody's watching it. If anybody hasn't got the internet, they can't get it. It's on the internet, the whole explanation of it, there's no need for me to say it without the videos, it cuts things short. Show the video. Yeah, but the video is long, it's about an hour and a half for the whole complete thing with the agenda. It saved me talking. If people had a camera rolling there off the laptop, you'll see what I'm saying. Because everybody in the country, in the world is watching. The Americans and the British are watching what I'm saying and reading everything. They know more, too. See, they know what I'm talking about, because I'm in front of the world with the flag, not just up the road. Yeah. It doesn't take me long. It doesn't take me long. But the thing is, I will just tell what's in the video, and they can watch it from somebody's video. It's better because it's on YouTube. Yeah, no, it has to be done. I don't need much time. I just need to be there physically to explain it like how I did the last time. Yeah, okay. Okay, bye. You see how hard it is to communicate with my own people. And yet, people around the world get it just like that. Oh, he's Kingi. That's Kingi. Yes, he did ring. He rang while I was talking. just let him ring again. So I'm ready to meet Kingi now that everything's set in place. The Navy's set in place, the Marae, Waitangi Marae is set in place, and the flag is set in place, ready to go. But I'm surprised that Willie is standing off a bit, like half an hour for me to talk for something as important as what I'm just saying on this video. I'd need a whole day. That's how this is. So I'll have my say on that marae, on Waitangi marae, I'll have a say on there as long as I want. Okay, we got 2 hours on that day because I've hired it for this occasion again. I hired it before, Willie, on the 15th, the last time we went into Waitangi Marae. I hired that Marae. It took me a bit to actually get it against the grain. I don't think anybody else could have done that with its purpose. Why? They let me have it. You know what Willie said? They said, we can't stop you, Don. You know why? It's because the information out there is stacking up to that marae and that land. The land and whose hapu, Ngati Kawa, and their chief. Because Kingi is proficient in his job as the chief of Te Ti Marae and the Waitangi Land Blocks and the oldest, he has to please the Crown Corporation in Wellington, which is fine by me. I don't take sides. I'm balancing act here in the middle. It's not my land. It's Ngā Puhi's land and Ngā Puhi's say. I'm only here as a commercial contract advisory, as a native assessor, land commissioner between here, Britain, and the rest of the world with this land is gone. Okay, it's got a broader cover rather than just those pieces of land in Ngā Puhi and the rest of this country. You have to try and bring all your Maoris together. It's very hard because I've been trying to do that for over 20 years. It's never worked. They don't talk to each other. They keep their information to themselves. You see? They don't let it out. They keep it to themselves. And so, although Hohepa, Hohepa's doing the Whakameninga and putting all that history together, there's a lot of bits missing. If I didn't say anything, it would never come up. The Crown will look at it and say, sorry, you got one bit missing. That's what I'm saying, Willie and Hohepa. There's one missing link. And if there's one missing link not there, the contract falls over. You can't engage. They won't listen. Not even Britain will listen. Not even the Crown Corporation's private business in Wellington. This private. They're using this flag for private business. If I don't tell you this, you won't ever know. You will never know unless you know what you're talking about in commercial law and law of the land. All of that crammed in this flag. If you don't know what you're flying the flag for, then you wouldn't know if I didn't tell you. But I'm telling the whole world. So you're not the only ones that are learning the hidden bits. And even the Moai statue is being hidden away. They're using that too, that memorial. They're using that memorial, they're using Kupe's memorial for their private contracts on that side, left side. Okay, you get the picture? You get what I'm saying? I've been at it too long that I wish it all floated away. And so I can get on with the tidal turbines in the water. So you look after the land, Taumata, Kaumatua. Your job is to look after the marae, not to mess around with what I'm doing. The rangatiras will do that. And Patrika, right? Patrick, if you're watching the video, it's your job to do the commercial bits. But you're in tikanga and Te Ture Whenua Act. It doesn't work on this side. There's no Te Ture Whenua on this side in Britain to the hapu. There was no Te Ture Whenua Act 93 that you go under here, and UCC laws and canon law, civil law and admiralty law, vice admiral on this side. Admiral, not vice. Admiral on this side. Okay? and laws, land laws of England, 1838 and 37, those are laws I'm using forever. No one can stop me. Okay? No one can stop. That's what I'm using on Cook Street. This one in the Manukau land title. I'll use the Ututonga land title in Waitangi. Don't anybody try to tamper with it, because you'll get in trouble the same way as the police did on Cook Street. Going to string them out one by one in the court. Auckland District Court will be extended from Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, King's Bench Court. There's no one talking about the King. There's no one talking for the King, however. I'm here as his surrogate to go to London with King. I'm not taking anybody else because there's no need for a crowd. Kingi is a war veteran. He has every right to go as a war veteran to speak for the military and the Navy and the British military, Navy, direct in Maori to complete the link. Okay? You can't go half full. You can't go half full. All the incorporations are operating under the Te Ture Whenua Act. Is John Key's authority. It was created by John Key for his commercial purposes. Unless you got your own government, it's very difficult. We've been trying to put a government together for a long, long time. Mohi Manukau and all the rest of them. Been trying to do that. Alf Mitchell, he's in our age group with Patrick. And struggling because we all got different titles. Patrick is more the land man of the land, and his ex, they've got their documents, that's fine. But they're clouded by John Key. They have a big job, even the Mokopuna lady, I forget what her name is, she's got the Moko, went to Wellington to John Key with her documents, you see, because she wrote to the Queen, and the Queen wrote back and said, go and see my representative, Governor General. So she goes, she says, no, I'll go and see John Key. And the Governor General says, go and see John Key. So it's gone right around the corner and back again. That's what happened before with a lot of others who did the same thing, landed up back at John Key, because they'll shove it on to who's running the country, because they got no say, because you're standing on the land that this side put together. Okay, this side has to go to England to correct it. There's been others gone to England, but their surname is wrong. They'll say, sorry, your name doesn't fit. I go there because the Wānoa and the Māori statue go together. That's that mana whenua title there. Okay? Here, this side is tangata whenua. This side, mana whenua. Okay? You see the difference? You can't talk mana whenua here because you've got to have the full quid, not a half crown. Okay? I just want to clear that matter up legally, because if we went to court, if you didn't have the right information, they'll throw it out. That's why I'm contesting the land, every piece of land here and around the world, for that matter, with their flag. Their flag is very powerful if you know how to use it. Not many people can do that without your name stuck to a memorial. You have to have a memorial, okay? Nga Puhi's memorial is on top of One Tree Hill. Well, it's not theirs, it's John Campbell's, but they've conveniently put Kupia there. Kupia should be standing up there, not John Campbell. Mohi Manukau says, pull the thing down. That's what he told me to do before he died. John, I want you to pull it down and put up the original Kawharu title. Right? You can put Kawharu there and Puhi, that's fine by me, as long as it's a native. Right? As long as it's a native surname. Surname, Ohepa, has to measure up. You have to have the right name. You can't talk otherwise. Oh. Hello, Kingi. Oh, shucks. Kingi, oh, you've been trying to get me. Oh, no, I was talking to Willie. Willie Peter up in Otaua. Those fellas they're a bit coy about what I'm doing. So, so I said, oh, no, you don't work like that. You go and hire the Marae and see if you can try and get it. All right? But anyway, where are you now? Are you back?
Oh, no, I'm still down here.
Oh, I see. That's all right. Were you trying to get a hold of me?
No.
Oh, I thought I saw my phone thing up with a message on.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Yeah, no, I thought you weren't there. That's why I rang twice. So when are you coming back? Doesn't matter. Plenty time. Oh, okay, that's all right. Yeah, no problem. Now those fellas have been having a good talk, and I just told them, don't muck around with commercial stuff. You just look after what you do, and tell the Taumata to do a Taumata job. And leave the things to what we're doing, okay? Yeah, so at the end of the day, Kingi, they can talk as much as they like, but when it comes inside the whare, it's yours. I do. I'm getting annoyed with them. When they get a whiff of what I'm saying online, then away they go. They're trying to own the thing, you know? And say, oh, we're going to do all the talking. I said to them, well, you go and hire the Marae, I'll turn it all off and you try and get it. Anyway, that's aside, not worry about it. I just lined it up for you for that 2 hours with the Navy. I'm hoping that they, John passed it on to the other cultural ones for the kapa'aka from the Navy. The Waitangi's kapa'aka will be there when the flag goes up. When the flag is being raised, the kapa'aka will kick in and the 21 gun salute will go off. That's what I'm. So I'm hoping that they're not going to mess around and talk and start talking and burn the time up. So that's all I rang for, Kingi. Don't worry about them. I'll sort them out. No. How are you down there? You're eating lots of seafood. You having big feed of seafood too, Kinnis? Oh, I see. How's that going? All right? Good?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Good, that's good. Okay. Yeah, well, we'll see you later, mate. Have a nice day. We'll see you when you get back. Bye. There, that's the chief. The thing with Kingi and me is that we've known each other, and Sunakura, we've known each other all these years with the Confederation. So it was hard for me because I couldn't get a straight answer from him because he was, like he is now, working in the Crown side. Nothing wrong with that. That's his job. He represents other Marae's and his own and taking message there. That's a corporate thing. It's not the Taumata at home. So he's got a radio station to talk to the masses, and that gets extended into the Pacific. So he's a mouthpiece for a lot more things than just standing on the Marae and talking. That's for him and myself. We get frustrated when people talk about other things and burn up time. I'm just telling them, for the time we have on that Marae, the Waitangi Marae, because I've arranged it again, write letters, letterhead, stamps, seals, flags, and everything. Everything's in place forever. Nothing's missing. And the name to go with it. Okay? So if your name's Maori and it doesn't stack up to its back history, right back. If your name is an old name, Parapara, it's come way back and it's still Parapara now. The same man. Right? Man to man to man to man to man. That's tikanga law. That's how tikanga, L-O-R-E, law works. Male dominant, not female. Male dominant to keep the title on the land. The female busted the whole lot up. Or hepa. It busted all the titles that everyone's on these lands is under a woman that's fraudulent, corrupted, and you're stuck right in the middle of it and trying to get out of it. It's impossible without another Maori government to do that. I can't see it happening right away. Here on this side, we've got a Moai crown in London, in Dunedin. Moai crown, real memorial. Moai crown, Commonwealth Government of the World. We can call it what we like because it's the king's business. I'm here to talk for the king and the Hapu native with the right surname. Okay, with no body Maori names. I'll make that clear. Anybody talking on their feet has to whakapapa back to their original name. If you're mucking around with a name that's been changed or put there or fashioned by Pākehā, you're in trouble with me and Kingi. I'm telling him what happens. Okay? There's too much of that corruption going on to get on the land. I'm investigating all lands in this country for the sake of the whakameninga and for the British. See, they leave that for us to sort out because they got the records over there. They uplifted all the records and I have to match them up when I go there to Glasgow. I go to Glasgow because that's where all the titles here from Glasgow, where my secretary is. Jackie Little of Gordon in Aberdeenshire. She's there for the Moai King William Party and Moai Crown King William Trust. We set up there and here in New Zealand. Okay? And the company, Moai Powerhouse Group Limited in London. So she's with Matt Taylor as the secretary of that company in England. Britain, UK, operating out of Brighton, up from Sussex. Okay, so we've got that in place. That's as far as I'm going, Ohepa, and Willie, and Jim Wekotu, down in Whakatohe, Whakatane, that area, Opariki, Tuhoi, area. I'm saying the Matatua is very much involved with Nga Puhi in these commercial affairs here to sort out. It's going to take a long time for any incorporations or Maori government to take stock. It's impossible. So rather than that, I've been through all of that, the incorporations, I mean the incorporations, Potikirua Ki Waipu incorporation at Rangitukia and Te Araroa and Lot Point. Runaway area and Port Awanui, Rotore East, our area of Uataha goes from Tikitiki, Rangitukia to Tikitiki to Maraihara to the back of Maraihara to Whakaangiangi and across to Cape Runaway, straight from there, straight line through to Cape Runaway, back to Portaka, Hicks Bay, Matakawa. And around to Te Araroa, Uruera, East Cape, Lighthouse, Whanakoina Island, and that's the East Island. And around the other side to the Haha land blocks where the Te Pito is, to Te Pito in East Island there, first light, sun in the world there. And birth of New Zealand there, Te Pito, Pito, there, marked on Google map, and Rapa Nui to Muka Nui, Urupa, of my Wānoa people, straight to Rapa Nui, from there, from Muka Nui to Rapa Nui, Moko Nui, big, to Rapa, big son, Nui, big son, Rapa, big shine. There, Rapa Nui to Moka Nui. Okay, so from there, that point, to our history of the Moai, down to Rangitukia, Haho, Simbi, Brook, and across the river, Waiapu, to Port Awanui. But the boundary area ends at Waiapu River mouth, back to the back of Tikitiki and Maraihara and back around to Cape Runway through Whakangeni at the back Rokumara Range, along there. That's our Uetaha boundary area. The other side of that in Ruatoria, at Port Awanui, and up to Te Puia, Tukumaru Bay, across to the sea, is in Mount Hikarangi, is Sunakara, where Pohatu. So those are the land titles that I'm dealing with there, with those two tupunas. Okay, and the mountain has been significant to our titles, and Sunakara is more woman chief. That's overrun everybody else because she's got the reo, she's got the everything, she's got the mindset for commercial operations. She's the premise of the Maori government that's strung everything together with these four regions that I said. Te Taitokoro, north. Te Tairawhiti, east. Te Taitanga, south island. Te Taihauuru, west. The premise of Whanganui, those areas. Mount Egmont, right? That mountain, Mount Egmont, South Island, Mount Cook, Gisborne and the East Coast, Mount Hikarangi. Okay? So that's that, and there's Hikarangi up north. Hikarangi there, Moyra. And a Hikarangi down, Palmerston North, down that way. Manukau down there as well. So there you go. That gives you a plan outline of everything that's crammed in my head and the flag. Why I can talk like that. Okay, so Kingi's just got off the phone to me. He's still away. He's busy. He'll be back tonight. Again, he said that yesterday and the day before. So no rush on that. So I'm going to give a presentation for less than a half an hour on the term. This is how hard it is. It's best if I have my own hui so I can have the whole 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, the whole day to get it across, because they're only picking up bits and pieces and running off and doing things and saying this and this and that about what we're going to do in the Waitangi Marae. They're going, the Taumata by default of land, especially Nga Puhi land, has the right to go into Marae, but no one's bothered to do it. So I'm there to do it for them, not for me. And my little endures, it's for them. But the thing is, I need someone who knows what they're talking about, not so much history. We're going in there for the commercial flag side. Nobody wants to hear about everything else because they've heard it before. There's no need to talk about anything else other than where we're going to with this flag around the world. And how are you going to fix this country up and address the issues? You see, they don't know how to convert that into revenue. None of them. They need to go to school to learn economics and how to do trade. The Pākehā way, right? They've had 182 years. I'm talking about us, Maori people. We've had 182 years to pick this all up, and real estate especially with land, because there's everybody else using it too. They've got a right too. Everybody's got a right to be on land. It's only the crooked ones I'm going after. And so with Ngā Puhi and all the other tribes, I'm here talking about all the tribes, they've got a problem with their land. They've always had a problem with the land. Pākehā comes along, John Key's coming and steal it. That's what I say, steal it. Because they got a piece of paper to steal it. And there's no one putting up a fight because it costs money to go to court and to go to tribunals. You need a lot of time that you really don't have to go and try and fight for your land back when it's yours. This one fixes it. It'll fix it if you know how. And you've got to learn how to do that too. So half an hour is not enough for me to do a presentation on everything I'm doing. Because it's too much for anybody to observe in one time, especially Taumata, the older people above me. It's too much information to absorb and try and do something with, because if I give it to them, what they're going to do with it? See? They'll only go and do the same thing they do all the time inside their fire, talk about what they do. No one's going to listen to it in commerce. No one's going to listen to it in commerce because it's not a plan, draft plan, of what they want to do with the land. It's not a draft plan to put figures together and who's going to buy it. It's either for themselves and no one else with that little piece of land. So if you take the land title you've got, you're subjected to John Key's government because those are their documents, they're not yours, they are theirs. Tikanga law and their law works to a certain extent, not always, not always. Te Ture Whenua Act is a contract. It is a contract between Westminster, Parliament and the hapu. Now the hapu can use that effectively only for the hapu who uses it. That's what I'm saying. The hapus hold it to themselves, they won't show anybody. They won't show anybody what they got. So they do their own thing. They can't express it and have hui here telling them what they're going to do. The ones in corporations have a hard time to convince this side or John Key's side that they are above the law or complying with the law. In some ways, they have to comply with the law or they've got the law unto themselves. That is the license to this country. Te Ture Whenua 93 Land Act is the title, legacy, and license to run this country because the government's using it. So what they've done is they've corrupted it, and it's made this one corrupted too. So everything that they deal with the government here is corrupted. That's why I said, I'm not going to look at that. I don't even follow the Te Ture Whenua Act. I'm going straight under the 1835 Declaration of Independence Constitution and the Acts of King William IV, 1838 and 37. Now, no one's going to use that on their side because they have no authority to use it and can't talk to it, right? You have to have the titles, the everything with it to Britain. This side doesn't have that. They have to stick with the status quo and John Key's government. Have to comply with them and their titles. The incorporations are using John Key's titles on those lands that are being surveyed to stake their claim. So they're picking off those land blocks that they're claiming and sitting on it, and that's as far as they go. They can't commercially operate on a sense like that. It's domesticated, subjected to what the incorporation says. So it's just another incorporation arm of the other John Key's incorporations with Te Ture Whenua Native Land Act. Okay? I notice if you see Australia is using that same 1993 Land Act for their native title too. That's the one I challenged. I challenged that when I wrote to the Victoria government before they took that Commonwealth title. That the Commonwealth of Australia title I'm talking about. There's three titles. Commonwealth title of Australia, state government, and the federal state government. Three. Different titles in Australia, same as America and Canada. All right? The Commonwealth countries are using those because they are using the Queen. They're using the Queen, Elizabeth, to defraud the land and the people. Same with Hillary Clinton and Obama. They're using the same law of the Queen and a federal state, right? That's her ownership. She owns America and this country on their bits of paper. So you're really buying it back off her on a Maori land title. You're buying the land off her. Here, one shot, got the lot. This is the House of Cards. This is the instrument to rescind or execute the House of Cards right here in this side, 1834. Okay, so if I didn't tell anybody, you wouldn't know. It'll be still in my head, so it's best to throw it out there and see who is going to try and talk to it. Taumata, my advice to you is Do not get mixed up in contracts. You're there to protect the land. I'm going into the sea. That land. Beyond the international waters, beyond the territorial waters, 12 mile limit here and the 200 mile limit. This side has already got a 500 mile limit. This side's got a left side, queen side, to New Zealand's got a 200 mile limit, economic zone. So all of that I've got documented here online. All right, it's a lot, it's too much for a little one hapu meeting. Right? You need a university for that. To take that into. So this video is long. I just wanted to make sure that everyone know what I'm talking about. And I'm sure that the people in America that have been following me for years, I've got up to my limit now on Facebook, 500. So I'm going to kick off another site, one of 68 other Facebook sites, and start up again another 5,000. Okay, so that's how that works. So nobody can, there's got a lot of people pouring in the last 2 months and jumping in behind me. So we've got a lot of people. I'm ringing Sunakura again. Now, that's it. I thought I'd ring one more time. So really, that's it. I can go up to the gym shortly and spend a bit more time because I was running out of time going there. Yesterday I didn't go because it took me a long time to finish off what I was doing with the Navy. And I'm hoping John Martin from the Navy, the Rear Admiral John Martin, Chief of Navy, New Zealand, that he will organize a 21-gun salute for this flag. That's just to be polite and honor, in honor of the British who got here, like Hoffman's. I forget what her name is now. I've got to go look for it. Anyway, I will look for. I'll go and get it so that I know who I'm saying. Moyra, that's my friend Moyra. Moyra, hi Moyra. I know she watches all these videos, just like a lot of English people watch these videos, and Americans, and other people for that matter. So to Moyra and Kurt, put a little clip in here that the Russells, your maiden name Moyra, come from Russell, Kororareka, where I'm talking about this side, the King side, straight to Britain. So, I know you're passionate with Nga Puhi, always have, lived in Hokianga and up in Russell, but Hokianga, and you know all the history of the Hokianga Māoris in that time. I hope that you might come up and we go up together again, and Sunakura can be there too, so you can meet with her again on this occasion, and we hope we have the full fanfare for this flag celebration of 182 years since your family, Russell's, first got to Russell and put that name on that township. Okay, that's to get a plug-in for your family and with the Hoffmans being friends of mine in Rotorua. I think that's about wraps it up. Of explaining some more of what we are achieving with this flag, and I'll just explain something about the Māori Crown Commonwealth Government of the World. This is an overarching government with this flag of the New World Order, which the Pope has taken because the Queen gave it to him, the title out of Westminster. So I'm going to England to bring it back into Westminster, this New World Order, because with the way things are going, Putin wants them out. He wants them out because it's full of those people who are the elite, Gabel and Rothschilds and George Soros and everybody throwing all their money they've stolen off other people in their countries with their crown corporations and banks that this side will address in Westminster. We're talking here, I'm talking here for the King, William, and for to nominate King Ernest Augustus the Fifth into Westminster to fill the void of the King, to correct, make a correction to all that's happening on that side, the left side, where the marriages are stuck with TPPA and John Key and corporations on that side. This corporation, I'm saying this one for the British military and Navy, that we are hoping that someone will pick it up, that the Navy and the British should be here. They should be here to celebrate our contract with you, private contract with you, with a 21-gun salute at Waitangi on the treaty grounds, on the flagstaff pole of your ship, of Admiralty, British ship, that one. I'm hoping that you'll see me on the video and come and honour your obligations to us as our partners. You are our commercial trading bank of England partners in business. Still, 182 years later, we are holding this flag, flying it for nothing. We are flying it because we have that contract intact, unbroken sovereignty of our own to Britain. King William the Fourth has his own sovereignty that we swear our oath of office to, and his successor, King Ernest Augustus V, and his son, Ernest Augustus, Prince Regent. We swear our oath of office to Britain and Westminster and the British military and the British Navy to him and his son, in the first instance, to the chiefs, Kingi Taurua and his Taumata chiefs of Nga Puhi and the rest of the Confederation of Chiefs around the country after that, after the Whakameninga and the rest of the chiefs around New Zealand. They're so on the side of John Key and Iwi Māori here that it's very difficult to shift them onto this side without making the first move. I'm making the first move with Kingi Taurua here. He's the military man that can address military matters because this is a military flag of commerce on the high seas. Okay? And trading around the world. We're trading around the world with this flag already from the 15th of April 2016 this year, based on the 10th of April 1834 flag contract, first arrivals of the British military, Navy, and their families and agents around. Okay? So that's that part of what I'm talking to. More so the Taumata and the chiefs will look after that side of this flag. So to you, Willie, Peter, and your Otaua Marae, you are holding the flag with the rangatiras and your Taumata of the Whakameninga inside that marae. Okay? You have your say inside that flag. I'm there for the commercial card. Nothing else. Okay? It's not my call. When it comes to the land, that's your call. Kingi Taurua, on the other hand, is Queen Victoria to speak for the commercial side of banking and revenue. That's my business. That's my business. Through the rest of the world, from that Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court. It's a court now. That's why I hired it on the 15th of April this year. For that very reason, to open it up for business. Okay, because John Key's using that for his business. So we've gone in there in tandem with the British government you might as well say this side is a British government under the Marae Crown, Commonwealth Government of the World, under the Kings. Okay, so the people in Britain and America and Darryl Payen, he's our agent there under the Moai King William Trust and the Moai Powerhouse Group Limited organization in London and New Zealand, because he's been with me long enough. We've had our ups and downs, but I've made my mind up. I'm quite happy with him and his other partner, I've forgot her name now, her, as being trustworthy enough to look after things in California. Okay, so we've got that, the Queensland there, with King George III title on these, King George Red Cross and Vatican Red Cross title in America, under this flag. They're subjected to this flag, Darryl and Matt Taylor in London, England, UK. The Commonwealth governments, including America, is subjected to this flag of Admiralty court martial law. That's where it come out. Okay? In the commercial field of banknotes, gold coins, currency, Bank of England Acts, under King William's Acts of Parliament. Unaltered. No one can tamper with those laws from 1830 to 1837 with us, the Hapu Native, for all the other indigenous natives in the world, including Dakota natives in America. This flag will fix your problem up with the land. Once we get ours sorted, yours will be sorted. And all the other, India, Northgate, Africa, Australia, Pacific Islands, all those lands will come subject to this flag. Okay? The Taumata, on the other hand, in Nga Puhi, in particular Nga Puhi, because the piece of land I'm talking about, things stuck to the land and who was there. So because the ship is on Waitangi land block, that is their Marae's say. Just to make it clear, Māori Rapana, that's your land to talk to, that the ship landed on. And Kingi Taurua, the oldest one of you, until there's a successor to Te Ti Marae, to speak from the Hapu side, because at the moment it's the iwi side talking inside that whare, or house, courthouse. And we're turning that courthouse back to the Hapu to come and talk with the iwis as one block. And the rest of the country, that there is intentions to shift the Treaty of Waitangi Day into that marae, and that's what's happening here. That's what's happening here because of the way it's looking. I read into all of that. I read the news of the world every day. It takes me a long time, 5 hours sometimes, just to read what's happening in the world. And that's another thing a lot of people don't do online. They say, oh, they don't go on Facebook. Facebook is more accurate than the media news. BBC News, NBC, all the rest of the news, Fox and all the rest of them, Reuters. It's not as accurate as right to the minute something's recorded and goes straight online. Okay? That's evidence. You can see the voting in America where Hillary Clinton's getting caught. Hillary Clinton getting caught because someone's filming. Even Aaron Smith with that girl in the Auckland airport. That's a shame. It's a shame on the sport that one of their ranks pulls out, top man pulls out and does that in front of the whole world because someone videoed it. And the right to video anything suspicious is information that no one would have. That's what I'm saying. I throw everything out because it's no use in my head. I throw everything. Same as that person who is now charged with privacy. That toilet was for disabled people. They weren't disabled. They were very able. And a lot of noise going on the video camera. You see, now the person that took it is in trouble because the law said you can't do that after the fact. They'll lose the case, not the one with the camera. The others will lose the case because it's not a public place. It's for disabled people, like disabled parking. You get a parking ticket. They should have got a parking ticket for being in a disabled area, occupying it for that period of time. If they had a coin meter on the outside, they put the coin in, didn't go and do their dirty business, didn't come out. Shame on rugby, and shame on John Key trying to use the rugby flag and the emblem of the fern for his New Zealand flag. Shame on that too, because it failed. People didn't want to go away from the war flag, the Union Jack flag, that's got more substance to it and history. And the fern has only got a kiwi underneath it that can't fly and is growing as greenery to this country's symbol, and they've turned it into something of corporate for their own financial investment interests. That's what I'm saying. This side, John Key's government, is for his own financial investment interests, the same as what happened with Cook Street. Financial interests of their own, and the police covered it up for their own financial interests, and the judge covered it up for his own financial interest of my birth certificate. He cashed it in after the bundle of papers that Natalie Flower June Brown used, fashioned, and arrested me, put me in prison. I went in prison there because of those fraud papers. The judge threw it out on the 22nd of September of this year, 2016, dismissed a police CIB case against me because of lack of evidence. No, it wasn't a lack of evidence. It was because I've had too much evidence online, on videos, and on Facebook and Twitter. Just too much that everybody knows. You can't make a court case when everybody knows. You spill the beans. So what happened was, it should have defunct everything, but those papers moved through the courts, moved through the prison, moved through the courts, and then they cashed the money to pay themselves, including my barrister. I'm taking them into court, but they don't care because it's only one or two, and the march goes on with the fraud. You see? They say, oh, it's only one person, so it doesn't matter if we lose a few thousand or million. There's plenty more fraud left after that. You see? So this one, the King's Bench Court knocks it out. Okay? The House of Cards this side, sledgehammer this side. Okay? Knocks it out. Okay? So I just wanted to say in that video that this is the distinguished area, Moyra and Kingi. Kingi knows, because I'm telling him all the time. I'm having constant talks with him all the time. Because although we've been with each other, he didn't like me in the first place because of Mohi Manukau. He hated Mohi Manukau because they used to battle all the time. And Mohi Manukau will say this inside the Tiki Marae. When they say, well, your turn. Because they went right around and said, which is your waka? Right? That's what Mohi said. I'll never forget. Mohi says, they asked all the chiefs from their hapu to tell them which waka they came on. And when I got to Mohi, as clever as he is, he got up and he says, well, I was sitting in the kua kahuta tree and I watched all your wakas coming. Meaning to say, I was here. I got no waka. I was here. And you first came here. See? So that's the Manukau title. But anyway, we won't go down any further than that. That's in the past now. I just want to chuckle over that one. There's plenty more, but he was a humorous guy and said nothing in the corner all the time. Now, he says, don't listen to that lot. Listen to me. He says, don't listen to Machitawa. Don't listen to Richie Kake. Don't listen to anybody. He would listen to Hare Utatonga only. You see, the two original title holders would only talk to each other. That's where I come right in the middle of it. In their huis, when they first had their Confederation hui, and I turns up there. I said, what's he doing here? What's he doing here in the meeting? He says, he wants to say something about seaweed, aquifers. And so that's how it started off with aquifers. Right? So away I went with aquifers. He said, what's that got to do with the Confederation? I said, everything, it's trade. So from that time on, I was told, no, you sit down. And from then on, that was years ago, at Del Wihungi's place. That's where it first started. I go there all the time. And Mohi says, meet you there. And Rita Manukau would be with him sometimes. And I stayed at his place for 6 years. I didn't stay there. I stayed there sometimes, but I went there for 6 years to take Mohi Manukau around the whole of the Te Taitokoro area and the Taho Ouru area down to Ratara. Like all go around, video it. I've got all the video here and all the photos and all the stories I've written. I've written everything. When I went to his home, I'd be there late at night writing everything he's saying. You see, because he's the Rogan. The Rogans put the land titles here together in Gisborne and Manukau at Helensville. So I got all the Rogan titles. The Rogans married the Manukaus and the Wānoas. Right? That's the end of that. Right? To Britain. Straight through this flag. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm speaking, because the Rogans are in my blood when it comes to land titles and courthouses. The first courthouse in that area was at Helensville. The flag was flying there, but it's dilapidated now on that block where the courthouse was. And Mohi wanted to get the 10-acre block there back. Well, that's what I was doing at that time. I got all the documents for that title, right, including other titles that I put together for other people to get their land back. Now the time has come. It'll come at that point in time where there's somebody on the title occupying it. But the main point of what I'm trying to say is that don't alter anything. If someone's on the land, leave them there. Or if they're legitimate enough to stay there, leave them there, because there's plenty more land. Or just go and see the fraudsters and deal with that lot. Okay, we'll deal with the fraudsters in this King's Bench Court, in the Auckland District Court, that's the first one, and any other courthouse after that. Even the courthouse in Hokianga can kick off from this, but it has to be right. You can't be two tooth and half full. You have to be the full quid, right, to try and take that on, because no one's going to listen to anything that you say if it's not authorised or authenticated with original documents. So that's the commercial field I'm talking about. The banks, the pound note, we've got the pound notes out there, you can see them online, those are real. Those are real. The first fraud case will convert into the pound note. It's legal now because we legalized it in that marae on the 15th of April this year, 2016. We legalized the flag in there, and we legalized the pound note and gold coins and our Acts of Parliament 1837. Now all I had to do is express it from that side of Whakameninga to the Confederation of Chiefs of the, what they call the Hapu Native Incorporation around the country, okay, into that confederation, okay? So the incorporation has found it very difficult to talk to the Taumata for years. The Taumata would just throw them out of Te Tiki Marae, and that's why they end up in the paddock. That's as far as they go in the paddock, and that's all. Some succeed with land, some don't. Only the very few that know what to do. I know, I can't think off the top of my head, one or two of them that are proficient with documents. I've seen all the documents that everybody has. Some are effective, some are not. And so the Hapu and you up there, Patrick, you're doing a great job. up there, but it has to extend right to the rest of the country. That's why it's very difficult to bring all the Maoris together, because it's set up that it was too impossible to do, because they're so mixed up with Pākehā and are happy in their lot. And they don't want to go down the track of the Hapu incorporations, because it looks too hard to do and looks intimidating for people when you protest and all the rest of it. That doesn't bring any favours, but the attention is somewhat. I was there with the foreshore seabed, 2004, foreshore seabed Helen Clark. I was there right through the whole lot, including on the march to Wellington, and ended up in Parliament down there on the Foreshore Seabed Act with my own, one of 300 I was chosen out of 3,000 with a select committee to take my case in there. That was for the Manukau Y121 and my own Y number. I've never gone ahead with it, but I've got it on record as being my Y number case. Whenever I want to use it, I would use it, but not in that side. I use it on this side. I only use it as reference to the King's Bench Court, that I went through that process of the Foreshore and Seabed Act to bring it under this jurisdiction of Admiralty. This is only Vice Admiral jurisdiction, which is secondhand through Australia to Britain. This is the real Admiralty of this flag and the King, straight to Westminster and the military government. Okay, that's how it works. I'm here for the military, British military, King William, King. Okay? Not Queen, King. Right? This is Queen, King. This is King, that made the law on this side. Okay? Make myself clear, however? This is a class act on this video, just to put the message across what my position is, and respect your position, as a Taumata will do on their own marae. Okay, when Ngā Puhi comes together on that Waitangi block, bear in mind the land belongs to Ngāti Kawa Chief. You have yours in Matari Bay, and Ulipeta has his in Otaua, and so on. And I have mine at Waitā boundary area, like I was saying, from Cape Runway to Tingitingi to Rangitupia. There. I'm talking for that lot from this authority of Admiralty Court Martial Law, King of the High Seas, title. Surrogate King William the Fourth. That's who I'm talking for. Okay? However, no one's talked for the King before, on this side. No one. They're only talking to something in the flag, not to Britain. They're not talking on that end and this end. I have a representative on that end. In fact, I've got two representatives on that end, Sue Young and Matt Taylor. My friend Daryl Payan is watching all the time, because he got a handle on land law and titles and can follow everything I'm saying. They know, they're right up to it. Sue Young, Matt Taylor's right up to this commercial side of banking instruments and what to do. If I tell them, do this, do that, they can do it. Very hard to say that to Maoris. It'll be too much for them. You have to know the language inside the documents before you can apply them straight up. Okay? There's no hidden facts in this lot. Kingi, the last little bit of say I'll have for you on this video, and Sunakura. I'm hoping Sue will come up to Waitangi, Kingi. I'll send you this video to Radio Wātea, 6:03 a.m. So they're watching it too as well. If they are receiving it, they have the right to watch it and then give it to you. And the letters that I write to you through them, so that they have got a record there, and we have got everything on this video on record. For your marae, Te Te and Waitangi Kingi, which you take stock of both marais on the same piece of land. Waitangi, those are Waitangi land blocks. The Te Te land blocks are up the other side, Kereke. Okay, this is a Waitangi land block, but it's got Waitangi and Te Te land blocks at Te Te marae for the sake of convenience of the Crown to put the marae there with the hapus to form a marae next to the other. Okay, nothing wrong with that. It's just that the government wants Waitangi Day to be in the upper marae, or upper house. That is the upper house. The Te Te marae was trying to get together to make an upper house with Nuki Orich. This is one that's for you. I know you for a long, long time in the Confederation, and you did a lot of work to bring people together, and they weren't listening. They weren't listening. And you say, put it in the middle, on the floor. Some do, some don't. So it was very difficult to bring all the hapus around the country together in that whare. Now the other one has the ship next to it, and more power, gunfire, from Britain. We have the right, the inherent right, to have the British military to help us, because the New Zealand military is not helping us, because we have no money to pay them. That was what I got from the Navy, right? They won't help us. They're obligated to, but they won't help us because it doesn't pay their wages. We'll soon sort that out with this one, okay? Unless this happens, it's never going to happen. Kingi, it's never going to happen. If you and I don't complete the puzzle in our time before we go to see the angels, and I'll have the spaceship ready for that, okay? We're not going to go any other way. We'll fly there. Okay, and so we can come back in one piece and see if everything's going properly. Okay, I'll plan it out for us. Yeah, don't need any horses. We just need a spaceship. We'll make the gas for it. Okay, so that's all. That's all I want to say now. We'll leave it at that. I'll go to my gym now that I've got time and everything finished in place. Going to Otaua Marae on Wednesday next week. Have a little presentation, and that'll be my lot there before the 28th. 26th, 27th, 28th, I'll be up at Waitangi. Now, I want to go back up to Otaua because I want to make sure they got the message, what I'm saying here. And it's very important that the Taumatas who are meeting there in collective, there was 38 altogether, I remember, we were saying, that as long as I say what I'm saying, it belongs to them. Okay, it's how they apply it that matters. Willie? I'm better to say something than to keep it to myself and spring it on you at the last minute in that marae. If I didn't tell you, you would not be happy. I'm better to tell you, kanohi te kanohi. Face to face, all right? And Kingi, we'll meet tomorrow and run over a few things because we've got a job to do. We've got a big job to do. And you, with your responsibilities for that marae, I respect always. I respect you and your position to satisfy a lot of people on Te Te marae and Waitangi marae. And thank you to John Harrison, New Zealand, Royal New Zealand Navy, for letting me in the Auckland Navy, Devonport, for conveying the message to the other cultural manager in the Navy, and to John Martin, to let him know, to get consent for the Navy to help mark this occasion. I'm just a cog in the wheel of proceedings on that day, for the 2 hours from 5 to 7 a.m. And that's my lot. Te Te marae is everything else that will come under the taumata there of Kingi Tauru and the whakameninga. But for this celebration, on that marae for the very first time, second time, we've been in there on the 15th, of April. This is the second time we're going into that marae to mark this 182-year occasion. Okay, it's quite fitting in the history to be locked on the record in the Treaty Grounds Museum of what happened and what is going to happen from now on with the whole of New Zealand, not just Ngā Puhi or other Confederation tribes, but our part to play to go around the world with this flag trade. I'm taking this flag around the world through Britain, permission from Britain. After this, I write to Britain to get permission to come into Westminster Parliament and open our Parliament there, our political party, the Marae King William Party and the Marae Crown King William Trust over there in England, on his land in Plymouth, next to his memorial in William Yard. I'll be setting up there his jurisdiction with his flag. Up goes the flag there, next to his memorial, and the Marae statue in London Museum. We'll put the flag next to Marae statue as well to mark this occasion, and in Westminster Parliament and on the ships besides the British ship navies, air force and military. They'll be carrying this flag in dual government, Kingi, dual government around the world. This is a world flag, it's not just up the road from Ngā Puhi. The Ngā Puhi put it together to go around the world, not to stay at home. That's where I come in. Okay? Others will follow, but they need to be drafted into the organization. Okay? It'll take some process, and good to train up younger people in the marae there and other marae around the country to follow suit. I'll be there to put on little draft lessons to help to establish a combined New Zealand effort with the scouts of the Navy and Army and all those personnel to be saying the same things on the same book. Okay, so that's all. And to Jamie and her mum to get well, she's in the hospital and can't come to our celebrations. To her, my sympathies for the hardship they go through with her being in the hospital, and well wishes for her to get well. When I say sympathies, I mean the condition of when you get older, then you've got health problems and that creep on you, but I'm hoping that she'll be better and survive some more to see this through. Okay? So that's all for now. We'll catch you later. Have a nice day. Bye for now. John Wanaa, Oruhu, New Zealand.